Hi, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I'm here to do your daily vibes for around the, 21st, 22nd, 23rd, something like that, right? So the timing is fluid, and this reading may or may not be for you. Not every reading is for you, considering this is for thousands of people. There's no way I could read for every single person. Romance is in the air, right? I mean, it is. I can tell that it is. I just see rose, which means romance is in the air. So it is all about romance and feelings and growth in a relationship. Let's see. What do we got? Oh, we got the Hangman reverse and the Eight of Pentacles reverse. So this is somebody that's not putting in enough effort. Struggling. Okay, struggling. This is a big struggle. Somebody may be obsessed with control. Maybe they haven't learned their lessons. They may be refusing to go in and change their thinking. It's like they're just, you know, they're the same old, same old. And if you don't change things, then, and you don't evolve, then things continue to be the same. And you keep repeating the same mistakes. So it's like somebody keeps repeating the same mistakes, the same negative patterns, because they're refusing to see things differently or to do anything differently. So this is like missing an opportunity because of stubbornness, perhaps. Somebody may be, you know, they're just not going to do anything different. So, you know, if you're not going to do anything different, then everything stays the same and you continue to struggle. And you say, stay stuck. And you sacrifice new opportunities and good things from coming to you because you're refusing to change. So there's some sort of stubbornness here. Going by twos by the looks of things. And they're reversed. And so there's an absence of, and no, my deck isn't reversed. My deck isn't upside down. It's not, okay? So this is a horrendous loss. And somebody, like I said, somebody could be missing an opportunity. They're not seeing things clearly. They may be in a state of illusion. Now they're going backwards, repeating those patterns. Then, oh, geez, some crow. That is exactly what this card says. And I said it way before this card came out. So somebody is repeating their old negative patterns. They're in some sort of fantasy or illusion, or they just can't see clearly. But there could be a reality check that is coming because the moon reversed is a reality check. There's been some sort of fear, okay? Somebody, but now there's going to be some sort of release of fear because perhaps there's a higher power involved. There's unseen forces here. When you get the moon reversed, there could be some self-deception. So it feels like we have some, in protection, like we have somebody here that is protecting themselves. They're protecting themselves by staying in the safety zone, and it's really not getting them anywhere. It's really, really, really not. So, it's not, it's, I mean, when you get the Wheel of Fortune reverse, it could be a shocking, unpredictable loss because you keep going backwards, or you're not moving forward, or you're clinging to control, you're refusing to change. We definitely have somebody here that is refusing to change. They're refusing to do things differently. And I know I'm repeating myself because obviously you keep repeating yourself, right? Going back, you know, I'm going to keep doing it this way. No, 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 no. Now, when you get the moon reversed, there's a mental imbalance, right? Somebody is imbalanced here and they may be feeding themselves, their illusions with some sort of addiction or something, burying the truth. But this is a reality check because there's going to be a loss. Somebody is going to experience a huge loss and they're going to get a reality check. And I have to tell you, Pisces, Pisces. Now, I don't know if we're dealing with a Pisces, but we absolutely could be. So Wheel of Fortune reversed is bad luck. And we are about to jump into Pisces, right? Are we in Pisces yet? Yeah, Pisces. It's Pisces season. But we have somebody here that is giving up or not putting in effort. Stubborn as hell. Stubborn as hell. I refuse to change. I refuse to change a thing. That is what we got here. Ooh, the Emperor. We could be dealing with an Aries as well. We have an, this is a boss, okay? This is a business owner. This is somebody that is very controlling, very decisive, very much in charge, very masculine, uses his head, not his heart, makes his decisions based on facts. This person will show no weakness and is ready for battle. So this is battle ready. This is somebody who is very experienced and a fighter. So this is our Mars energy. So we have a fighter here who isn't going to budge, right? This guy doesn't budge. He's got a hard exterior. He has a lot of experience behind his back. Now, this masculine, and this is a masculine, is about to get a reality check. He's going to get a reality check of some sort. Or he's giving the reality check. He could be the one giving the reality check as well. Ooh, some light, shining the light. Now this one is shining the light on this one. So this is a higher consciousness. This is somebody who is very much consciously aware. This is a very wise individual that may be shining the light on this person, may be enlightening this person, or this person is going through some sort of enlightenment. Now the Hermit goes his own way, takes a time out to withdraw from the world, decides to give up and not put in effort. So this man, and I think it's a man, could be making a decision to withdraw and not put in effort. He may be deciding to just be like, you know what? I'm going my own way. I'm doing my own thing. Now we have 6 cards here, and 5 of them are majors. So that means this is universally driven. It means the universe is driving something, okay? But there's resistance. This is resistance to change. So we do have a masculine here that is resisting change. This guy is very controlling, likes to be in control. But he's about to go through some sort of awakening by the looks of things. And this could be a godly power, a higher power, okay? Somebody's about to go through some sort of awakening, okay? The universe is in charge here. All is not as it seems. So there's a higher power that is causing a change, whether this person wants it or not. This person is resisting it to no end. This person is stubborn as hell, okay? Really, stubborn as hell. Now, Page of Cups reversed. Frustrated, negative, repetitive patterns, negative behavior. We have somebody here that is obsessed with their image as well. They have an image problem. They're obsessed with how they look. Very egotistical. So we have a very egotistical person that is really focused on looks as well. Somebody's about to get a reality check. The Temperance reverse is going overboard. Something is off. So there could be an illness that is coming, because this is like, could be an onset of illness that is coming. So this could be a father or a husband or a boss that could be getting sick, no offense or anything. And there could be some sort of loss. Could even be a loss of a job. There could be, somebody could lose their job, just saying, okay. Now the Hermit is time to withdraw, it's time to reflect, it's about being alone. And this person listens to themselves only. It doesn't listen to anybody. So this person is like, I know it and I don't have to listen to anybody. So this is a know-it-all, right? This person really is. I'm not listening to anybody. So that's very evident here in this reading. We have somebody here that may be making themselves sick because of their ego. You know, their ego is humongous. Anyhow, the Temperance reverse is frustrated. Self-healing is needed. We have somebody here that is not healthy. They're acting. This is inappropriate behavior. And this is bad luck. So somebody is going to, in bad karma. So somebody may be experiencing some bad luck or some poor health or a loss of money or a loss of a job or something because of their ego, because of their pride, because of their, the way they handle situations, because of their stubbornness. You know what I mean? This person can't listen to anybody and will not listen to anybody. This person is very, my way or the highway. And this is unrequited love, the Page of Cups reversed. And this is somebody that may have... It feels like there could be some mother issues here with this card and this card. Maybe somebody didn't have a mother and it's turned them into a narcissist or something like that. There could be some mother, her absent mother issues or childhood issues here. Could even have to do with a father. Maybe it was an absent father or something like that. There's definitely some childhood issues here. Now it feels like there's going to be some tears or it's going to be very emotional with these two cards. There could be an emotional loss, okay? And this might have to do with a husband, father, boss, a masculine, okay? Emotional loss that could cause some upheaval because the Temperance reversed is upheaval, it's chaos, it's an imbalance, it's disharmony. And somebody could just get ill and it something, you know, it, you know, progresses to a loss. Okay. Queen of Cups. Now this, it could be a nurse. It could be a caregiver, a counselor. The Queen of Cups is tender, loving, care, very emotional. Very loving, very warm, very tender, very sensitive. Now, there could be a healer involved or a need for healing, a need for some care, a need for some love, a need to be delicate. Eight of Cups reversed, pretending to be happy. We could have a woman that is pretending to be happy. What happened here? Did that just move? I missed it. Anyway, I was looking over here and I think that, I don't know if I pushed it or what, could have. Anyway, this is pretending to be happy. Somebody that is shallow and superficial. There's lack of spiritual growth. So we could have a drama queen. Because this is a drama queen and this is a queen. So we could have a drama queen here that has been deceptive, has been lying. And this drama queen, and it doesn't have to be a drama queen. Not Page of Cups reverse, a drama queen. And this is pretending, and this is somebody has been pretending. They've been pretending. They've been pretending to love. They may have been working with somebody else, communicating with somebody else. Painting a pretty picture, right? They were painting a very pretty picture, but it wasn't real. Okay, this person really isn't happy. We have a feminine here who has been pretending to be happy, really pretending. All is not as it seems. We have a feminine here who has been pretending. She has been pretending. She's been pretending to be happy. She's been pretending to love. Perhaps this person, because this is realization. Perhaps we have this masculine that is starting to see. And now he is giving up. He is giving up. Because Eight of Pentacles is giving up. There could be a sudden departure. The Knight of Wands reverses sudden departure. It is. Somebody just, I don't want to do this anymore. I'm out of here. No thinking involved. This contract isn't compatible. This is the end of a contract. It's a split. There's going to be a conflict. There's going to be a detachment. A separation, a broken relationship. We have a split on this table. We have a split between a feminine and a masculine. The feminine has been pretending. And the masculine is waking up. And he is choosing to split. He's about to take charge of the situation. I just cut the deck. Death. Somebody's been held back by fear. They've been in a state of temporary stagnation. And this holding on has gotten too old. And they're just ready for an ending. There could be an upcoming disaster or an accident or an incident that causes somebody to leave after they have given their all to make it work. It's over. Just cut it again. The end. This is death. This is a death. This is a collapse. It's a breakdown. It's a catastrophe. It's the death of a situation. It's the straw that breaks the camel's back. Somebody has, it's like as low as you can go. They've reached the bottom. This is as low as you can go. I've never seen you go so low. It's over. Goodbye. So I see a goodbye. I do. Cut it again. Goodbye. Six of swords. Goodbye. Moving on. Going to a better place. Leaving that trouble behind. Somebody's moving on from a feminine who's been faking it. Good luck.